great time to meet you today on our lectures on English grammar course number one. Today we have unit 25, and we have here to see and show you the differences between the present simple and the present perfect. We have here when I do, when I have done, when and if, the difference between when and if. Study this example. Will you phone me tomorrow? Yes, I'll phone you when I get home from work. I'll phone you when I get home. When I get. Get here is referring to future, but we use the present simple. We don't use when I get. Here is a sentence with two parts. The main part here, I'll phone you, and here, when I get. So, when I get home. The time in the sentence is the future, tomorrow, but we use present tense, I get, in the when it goes, the when part. We do not use when in this part. We can have more examples. We'll go out when it stops raining. We go out when it stops, not when it will stop. When you are in London again, come and see us. When you are, yes, not when you will be. Say to a child, what do you want to be when you grow up? When you grow up, not when you grow up. The same thing happens and applies after while, before, after, as soon as, until, until. These are called time conjunctions. What time conjunctions? The tense here, when we are referring to the future, we use the present simple, not the future simple. I'm going to read a lot when I'm on holiday, not when I will be on holiday. I'll probably go back home on Sunday. I'll probably go back home on Sunday. Before I go, not before I will go, I'd like to visit the museum. Wait more here until or till I come back. I come back, not I will come back. We can also use the present perfect, have done, after, when, after, until, as soon as. For example, can I borrow that book when you finished with it? When you're finished with it, yes, don't stay or don't say anything while Ian is here. Wait until he has done. If you use the present perfect, one thing must be complete before the other. We have two things. One, and I mean, two things don't happen together. When I phoned Kate, we can have dinner. First, I'll phone Kate, and then after that, we can have dinner. Do not use the present perfect if the two things happen together. When I phone Kate, I'll ask her about the party. Yes. Yeah. Because I mean, at the same time, we don't use the present perfect. It is often possible to use either the present perfect simple or the present perfect. I'll come back. I'll come as soon as I finish, or I'll come as soon as I finish. You will feel better after you have something to eat, or you will feel better after you have had something to eat. After it, we normally use the present simple. If I do, if I see, etc. For the future, it's raining hard, will get wet if we go out. If we go out, we are safe enough if we will go out. I'll be angry if it happens again. If it happens, not if it will happen. Hurry up, hurry up. We don't, if we don't hurry, we'll be late. We don't. Right, now let's move to something else. We have comparison between when and if. We use when for things which are sure to happen. When something is certain or sure to happen, we are confident that it will happen, we use when. But if here we use if, and that is possibly, it will possibly, it will probably, perhaps it will happen, we don't know for sure, we are not confident, we are not certain about the event. So let's read these examples. I'm going shopping later. When I go shopping, I'll buy some food. That's certain. But if, not when, for things that will possibly, probably happen, may happen, perhaps they will happen. I might go shopping later. It's possible. If I go shopping, I'll buy something. That's not certain. If it is raining this evening, I won't go out. If it is raining, not when it is raining. I hope this point is made clear. If you have any questions, please let me know. Now, after the rules, we can now turn to do the exercises. The exercises are very important. You have to do these exercises to make sure that you have understood the rules. Without doing the exercises, you can't be confident. You can't make sure that you have understood the rules. The rules are quite simple, but they may be dry, they may be rough, they may be hard for some students to understand clearly and quickly. But after you have done the exercises, I think you will be certain, you will be sure that you have, made up your minds, you have understood the rules quite clearly, and you can apply these rules whenever you talk, whenever you speak, whenever you write, and you can also understand conversations, dialogues, you can understand, reading paragraphs, reading stories, reading anything. The grammatical rules are very important because they are the basics or the basis of the language. Without rules, without grammar, you can't speak well, you can't write well, you can't understand clearly the speeches, the writing documents, the news. Anything written or spoken in English, spoken or written, you must apply these rules. They are quite clear and simple, and try to make sure that you have understood them. And you can be so after you have done the exercise. Let's see. Exercise number one, that complete the sentences using the verbs in practice. All the sentences are about the future. Note that all of them are about the future. Use will or won't or the present simple. I see, he plays, it is, etc. Number one, this is an example. It is done for you. Number one, it is done for you. I'll phone you when I get home. From where? As we have seen, when I get, not when I will get. Although it refers to the future, it is in the present simple. In four, the fourth is the present simple. The meaning and the reference are referring to the future. Number two, I want to see Julia before she. We have go between brackets. Before she go out. Yes. Before she goes out, she's wrong to say she will go out. Number three, we are going on holiday tomorrow. Yes, I tell you about it when we come back. I'll tell you, I will tell you all about it, about holiday, when we come back. Not we will come back. Number four, Brian looks very different now. When you see him, see in brackets again, you will not recognize him. You will not know him because he is now quite different. He looks different. He seems different. So when you see him again, you won't recognize him. Number five, you be lonely without me. Why I be away, right? You will be lonely without me when I am away. When I am away, you will, feel or be lonely. Number six, we must do something soon before it be too late. It is wrong to say if it be late, no. We must do something soon before it is too late. Number seven, I don't want to go without you. I wait until you be ready. So I'll wait until you be ready. No, is ready. No, you are ready until you are ready. That's right. Number eight, Sue has applied for the job, but she isn't very well qualified. She's not very well qualified for it. I'd be surprised if she gets it. So I'll be surprised if she gets it, if she gets the job. Number nine, I hope to play tennis tomorrow if the weather be nice. I hope to play tennis tomorrow if the weather is nice. After if, never use when. That's number 10. I'm going out now. If anybody phone while I be out, can you make or take a message? So I'm going out if anybody phones while I'm away, can you take a message? Exercise number two. Make one sentence from two. That means join, connect the two sentences. Yeah, two parts. Using with when, yes, or yeah, when, after, before, until, if, and so on. Number one is an example. Number one is done for you. It will stop raining soon. Then we'll go out. So we'll go out when it stops raining. In England, it always rains. Number two, I'll find somewhere to live. Then I'll give you my address. So I'll give you my address when I find somewhere to live. Number three, if I'll do the shopping, then I'll come straight back home. So I'll come straight back home after I have done the shopping. It's going to get dark. And let's go home before that. So let's go home. Before it gets dark. Number five. She must apologize to me first. I won't speak to her until then. That's right. I won't speak to her until she apologizes to me. That's correct. That's right. Now, exercise number three, read the situations and complete the sentence. Number one, here's an example. Number one is done for you. A friend of yours is going on holidays. You want to know what she is going to do. You ask, what are you going to do when you are on holiday? Number two, a friend of yours is visiting you. She has to go there soon, but maybe there is time for some more coffee. You ask her, would you like some more coffee before you go out? Number three, you want to sell your car. Jim is interested in buying it, but he hasn't decided yet. You ask, can you let me know as soon as you decide to buy the car? Number four, your friends are going to New York soon. You want to know where they are going to stay. You ask them, where are you going to stay when you go to New York? Number five, the traffic is very bad in your town, but they are building a new road at the moment. You say, I think things will be better when they build or they have finished the new road. Let's turn to the final exercise. Exercise number four, we have put in or this put in or where it is necessary. Number one is an example. Number one is done for you. Don't worry if I'm late tonight. Number two, Tom might phone while I'm out this evening. And here we have, he does, can you take a message? Might here is possibly or not. So if he does, not when. Because we have here might phone, that is not certain, it's not sure. We are not confident that he will phone when I'm out this evening. Number two, or number three, I'm going to Rome next week. I'm there. I hope to visit a friend of mine. Yeah, it's certain. So when I'm there, when I'm in Rome, I hope to visit a friend of mine. Number four, I think Jill will get the job. I'll be very surprised, yes, if she doesn't get the job. Number five, I'm going shopping. That's certain. That's sure. So we can use when. When you want anything, I can get for you. Number six, that's the final item on this exercise. We have, I'm going away for a few days. I'll phone you when I get back. That's the end of this lesson. I hope that you have enjoyed this lesson. I hope that you have understood every item. If you have any questions, please let me know. That's the end today. Thank you for joining me. And goodbye. See you.